Have you ever wondered what triggers the deer rut in North Dakota? I'm Mike Anderson with the North Dakota Game and Fish Department. My guest this week is big game biologist Bill Jensen. Bill, what triggers the deer rut in North Dakota?
Well, in this part of the country, the primary driver is photo period, how long the daylight is and how long the nighttime is. That sets up the hormones in the animal that trigger the rut. The rut can vary from year to year. And the second driver appears to be the condition of the doe herd. If does are in real good condition, they tend to go into estrus earlier. If they're not in good condition, if they're very young or very old, those animals go into estrus later, and then that shifts the timing of the rut. Well, it's a process, and it starts in September and slowly builds. The peak of the rut for whitetails is generally between the 15th and 20th of November. For mule deer, it tends to be a little later, and then it slowly tapers off, finally finishing up with a few animals still actively breeding in late December.
Okay, what are some of the characteristics?
Physical appearance of the buck changes. Their necks swell. They are irritable to any other males in the neighborhood. They'll drive off other smaller bucks. They'll even drive off the male fawns of the doe. And they tend to focus on larger doe groups. If you're a dominant buck, you may be seeking out larger doe groups.
You'll see them kind of lick their lips and.
Oh, okay, yeah. There's felmining where they curl their lips. They're constantly checking does to see if they're in estrus, and just following.
Bill, do young bucks, do they rut as well?
They can. They can even be, in some cases, sexually mature at 6 months. But for the most part, it's yearlings and over. And sometimes you'll see a dominant buck, and then there might be a number of smaller satellite bucks hanging around, just watching, trying to sneak in.
Okay, and is it fair to say that they kind of let the bucks let their guard down during this time?
Well, they do. You know, if you're not reproducing, you might as well not have existed if you're an animal. So their full attention, is on trying to service a doe.
Okay, I've filmed many bucks in rut. And it's just, it seems like they just constantly are moving.
Yeah, it's a really an energy drain for them too. They don't feed, they're moving, they're constantly checking, they're fighting with other males. So by December, they're pretty well sapped. And a lot of those dominant bucks, they may die in January because they're just exhausted.
Okay, are there peak times throughout the day that the bucks are more active?
Deer tend to be more active at dawn and dusk, just as a general rule. But, you know, this time of the year during the rut, you know, males are moving around, constantly trying to find does. They're all moving a lot.
Is the deer rut the reason we have our deer gun season at the time we do?
Yeah, it is traditional in most states to have hunting seasons revolving around the rut. We need to be sure that there's enough males around to service the does for next year's fawn crop. This is a time when hunting has always traditionally been established. For whitetail deer, the breeding is highly synchronous. The fawns are born generally, the peak is June 6th. 70% of the fawns are born within plus or minus 2 weeks. Over 90% are born within 4 weeks of that date. So backdating to this time of the year, that puts it at about 15th to the 20th of November. That same synchrony is occurring with the breeding season.
Do the bucks become territorial during this time?
They become defensive of doe groups, not so much a particular piece of ground, you know, like some ungulates do. They'll move great distances this time of the year.
Before the rut, what are all these bucks doing?
Well, generally, a lot of them are in small bachelor groups. They're feeding, building up food reserves, fat for the rut and for the coming winter. So they're just out there hanging around.
Bucks are moving at this time of year. Motorists need to watch out on the roadways.
That's true. The bucks are moving from doe group to doe group. Does are moving around, and the bucks aren't really paying attention to traffic either. They've let their guard down to everything else, but you can have deer coming out of cornfields or tree rows, across roads, oblivious to traffic.
So early November through mid to late November, if you see a buck that's acting strange, it's probably the rut.
It's doing what it's supposed to do. It's being a deer.
A lot of great information, Bill. Thank you.
For more information on the deer rut in North Dakota, visit the Game and Fish Department's website at gf.nd.gov.
For big game biologist Bill Jensen and the rest of the staff here at the North Dakota Game and Fish Department, thanks for joining us for this week's program. We'll see you again next week.